The movie begins at noon in a market where an old man named Silk works as a pickpocket and knows how many wallets he has collected that day. At that time, a white dog named Snowy is following the pickpocket. In another place, there was a painter who was painting a young boy named Tintin. He was a young journalist. After his painting was finished, Tintin looked for Snowy. Meanwhile, two detectives were seen lurking behind their newspapers named Thompson and Thompson. In the end, Tintin finds Snowy, and at that time, he accidentally sees a replica of the ship in the mirror in front of him. Tintin was interested in the ship replica because he thought it was beautiful. The ship replica has three main sails and also 50 cannons. The ship was named Unicorn, which originated in the 16th century. Because the ship was so legendary, Tintin wanted to buy it, and it turned out that the replica ship was only sold for £1. Soon there was a detective named Dews interested in Tintin's ship. He wanted to buy it by offering twice the price Tintin had paid, but Tintin refused. The detective said he only wanted to help Tintin because Tintin would be in danger if he had a replica of the ship. After the detective left came to another man named Sakharine. Like the detective, Sakharine intends to buy Tintin's replica ship, and he will even give the price according to what Tintin wants. Still, again Tintin refuses and says he will not sell his ship even though he is offered anything. Arriving home, Tintin put the ship carefully and then looked for a magnifying glass found first by Snowy. The unexpected appearance of a stray cat that entered through the window of Tintin's house made Snowy lose his control. Snowy immediately chased the cat until it accidentally nudged Tintin's ship and made it fall. As a result of this incident, one of the ship's main masts was broken. When Tintin lifted the replica ship, a small iron fell from there, but unfortunately, Tintin did not see it. Snowy, who saw it, tried to pick it up, but it rolled under the cupboard. Tintin, curious about the ship's history, decided to go to the library to find out about the unicorn ship. On the other hand, someone watching his house might want to steal his ship's replica. Arriving at the library, Tintin found information about the unicorn ship. The unicorn sailed in 1676, captained by Sir Francis Haddock. At that time, the unicorn ship, which was carrying tobacco, was attacked by pirates because they suspected that the ship was carrying valuable secret goods. From the attack, none of the crew survived except Sir Francis Haddock. From the information obtained, Tintin became increasingly curious about what the unicorn ship was carrying. In the book, it is written that only Sir Francisco knows the answer. From behind the bookshelf, Detective Dews, who had bid on Tintin's ship that afternoon, was watching him, and then he left again because Tintin felt his presence. After returning from the library, Tintin was shocked that his miniature ship was missing. He then went to Marline Spike Hall, where Sakharine lived, because he believed Sakharine was the culprit who had stolen his ship replica. When he made it into the house courtyard, suddenly Tintin was attacked by a fierce dog. Fortunately, there was Snowy, who managed to make the fierce dog calm down. Tintin then entered the house through the window. After exploring the house, he found a replica of his unicorn ship. But unfortunately, Tintin was caught and caught the servant of the house named Nestor. When Sakharine arrives, Tintin claims that the ship is his. But when he checks, it turns out that the mast is not damaged. Tintin realized that the ship he was holding did belong to Sakharine. Then he returned the unicorn ship replica to him. After that, Tintin asked Sakharine why he wanted a replica of his unicorn ship when he already had one. But unfortunately, Tintin's question was not answered by Sakharine, and he told him to go home because it was late at night. Before going home, Nestor gave a little information to Tintin to find the missing part of his replica ship. Along the way home, Tintin became even more curious about his unicorn ship, plus he had just gotten information from Nestor. When Tintin arrived home, he was surprised to see his whole house in a mess. Snowy then led Tintin to find a small iron that fell under the cupboard. Tintin quickly moved the cupboard and found an iron under there, and when seen, it turned out that inside the iron was an old piece of paper that read three brothers merging unicorns into one and sailing by day and shining up to the cross of the eagle. Then under the note was a code that Tintin didn't know. He then kept the note in his wallet. Shortly after that came Detective Dews, who asked Tintin to be careful from now on because the game had started, and someone would kill anyone to get the unicorn ship. Tintin, who was still curious about the detective's intentions, was suddenly shocked by the sound of multiple shots that turned out to shoot the detective. Before dying, the detective gave a word clue in the newspaper while Tintin tried to chase the mysterious shooter but failed. The next day, Detective Thompson's brothers came to Tintin's house to investigate the death of Detective Dews. Tintin then told the two detectives that before dying, Detective Dews had left a message in the newspaper that read Karabujan. The two Detective Thompson brothers, who felt they knew something, then left Tintin's house. But in the middle of the road, one of them almost had his wallet stolen by Silk. Fortunately, the detective's wallet was secured. Silk, who had been caught, tried to escape and deliberately bumped into Tintin to steal his wallet. Tintin, who panicked because the secret paper was in his wallet, tried to chase Silk, but unfortunately, he failed. Tintin then asked the Thompson brothers for help to find his wallet. After handing over the problem to them, Tintin went home, but suddenly he was kidnapped by someone and put in a box labeled Caribugin. Seeing his master kidnapped, Snowy tried to pursue Tintin in various ways until he managed to get into a ship called Caribugin. It turns out that Sakharine's men kidnapped Tintin, and Sakharine is currently hijacking the ship. There Sakharine searched Tintin to find the unicorn ship note, but he found nothing. Then Sakharine tried to force Tintin to say where the note was, but Tintin firmly replied that he didn't have the note. Sakharine, annoyed because he didn't get what he wanted, ordered his men to torture Tintin until he answered. Soon, Snowy came to rescue Tintin. After getting out of prison, Tintin had the idea to escape from a window by tying a rope to the wood placed above the porthole to get to the room above. Before leaving, Tintin also prepared a trap that could prevent Sakharine's men from entering the room. And sure enough, when the criminals entered the room, they were immediately shot at by a liquor bottle cap which they thought was a real shot. Tintin and Snowy, who managed to escape, entered the room of a drunk man. The man immediately attacked Tintin because he thought Tintin was Sakharine's man. Then the drunk man explained to Tintin that he was the captain of the original Caribugin ship. Sakharine and all his men had betrayed him, and he was locked up in this room and given liquor every day so that he would get drunk and forget everything. But strangely, Sakharine did not kill him. Tintin, who knew the door to the room was unlocked, intended to escape but just walked out of the door. He instead met one of Sakharine's men who was carrying liquor. Then there was a fight between the two. Fortunately, the ship's captain immediately came to help him, and they could easily defeat the man. Then they carried the man into the captain's room. From there, they both began to get acquainted. And at that time, Tintin learned the captain's name was Archibald Haddock. Tintin was surprised to hear that his last name was the same as the captain of the unicorn ship. On the other hand, Sakharine, who already knew that Tintin and Captain Archibald had run away, immediately ordered his men to look for them. Sakharine said they could kill Tintin but not hurt Archibald because he needed him to solve the mystery of the unicorn ship belonging to his ancestors. In his attempt to escape with Tintin, Archie told Tintin that he had forgotten everything related to his ancestor Haddock due to the influence of the liquor he drank every day. Tintin then looked for other ways to find another Haddock, but Archie replied that Sir Francis Haddock's three sons had died and all his brothers had also died, and he was the last generation of Haddock. They finally found a way out, but unfortunately, the door was locked. Archie told Tintin to get the key from the fast asleep guard. After a long journey and a tense situation, Tintin finally managed to get the key. After that, Tintin gave Archie the key, and when the door was successfully opened, it turned out that the room was a liquor storage room. Tintin was upset because he felt tricked by Archie, who could not escape from alcohol. Archie then invited Tintin to escape using a lifeboat. When they arrived at the lifeboat, Tintin accidentally heard Sakharine's men say the Milanese Nightingale had landed. After knowing the clue, Tintin finds out Sakharine's plan, which turns out Sakharine intends to go to Bahar Baghdad, the place where the replica of the third unicorn ship is located. The Sultan of Baghdad owns the ship replica. Meanwhile, Captain Archie, who was waiting for Tintin, was suddenly attacked by Sakharine's men hiding in a lifeboat. Archie finally let go of the lifeboat rope he was holding and made the lifeboat fall into the sea. Archie then looked for another lifeboat while Tintin was struggling to avoid the pursuit of Sakharine's men and managed to climb into the lifeboat with Archie and Snowy. After Tintin managed to escape, Sakharine, who was on the ship, realized that Tintin already knew his plan to go to Baghdad. Sakharine then ordered his men to pursue Tintin and Archie. Sakharine's men found Tintin and Archie when they saw their lifeboat on fire due to Archie's carelessness, who felt cold at sea and burned his oars. But when he saw the fire burning, Archie instead doused it with liquor so that their lifeboat was destroyed by fire. Then they both saw the plane driven by Sakharine's men passing around them. Archie thought it was a commercial plane that could help them. Finally, Tintin intervened, and with one shot, Tintin managed to bring down the plane. He came there and took Sakharine's men hostage. Tintin then took over the plane and tried to control it. But unfortunately, their plane was caught in a sea storm and ran out of fuel. Tintin, who realized liquor was in the plane, asked Archie to put the drink in the fuel tank. Again, Archie messed up by drinking the liquor until it ran out. Archie, who felt guilty, climbed into the plane's muzzle and vomited all the liquor into the aircraft tank, and their plane managed to fly again. But Archie's troubles continued when he stood up and blocked Tintin's view, which made their plane crash in a desert. Meanwhile, elsewhere, the Detective Thompson brothers were about to meet Silk. Seeing the two detectives coming, Silk hurriedly entered his house followed by the Thompson brothers. In his house, Silk was seen collecting wallets from his pickpocketing. The Thompson brothers finally managed to find Tintin's wallet. The scene then moves to the desert. Tintin and Archie are stuck in the middle of a hot desert. As they both begin to tire, Archie begins to experience a mirage. Archie says he sees a beautiful ship with three large main deck masts and is also equipped with 50 cannons. Hearing that, Tintin felt sure that Archie's memory was slowly starting to return. Archie then began to tell him that the ship was carrying rum and tobacco and preparing to return home. Then Archie started telling stories about the past in the 16th century when Captain Sir Francis Haddock was facing off against a pirate ship. At that time, no single ship dared to fight the pirate ship except one, the Unicorn ship. Sir Francis ordered his crew to prepare cannons and attack the pirate ship. The battle was unavoidable. Their Unicorn ship started to burn, and the pirates began to board their ship. Sir Francis killed one by one the pirates who boarded the ship, and he also managed to keep his Unicorn ship away from the pirate ship. But it turned out that on his ship, there was still a pirate captain named. The story stops here because it turns out that Archie's mirage disappeared. The two of them, who were exhausted and dehydrated, finally collapsed, and at night the Baghdad army managed to find them and take them to their camp. When Tintin regained consciousness, he asked Archie about the Unicorn ship, but Archie couldn't remember. Fortunately, Snowy gave him liquor, and suddenly, he remembered and continued his story that the pirate captain named Red Rackham managed to capture Sir Francis. Because he felt his men were threatened, Sir Francis was forced to show the secret cargo to the pirate captain, which contained 400 kilograms of gold. After finding the treasure, Red breaks his promise and kills Sir Francis' crew members. Meanwhile, Sir Francis, who Red tied up, managed to untie his bonds using a small dagger. Sir Francis then went to the magazine room and intended to burn the ship. Unfortunately, when Sir Francis was pouring oil, he was caught by Red. They fought again, and finally, Sir Francis managed to defeat Red. Then Sir Francis blew up the ship. Sir Francis jumped into the sea, and the flying gold filled his great hat. Finally, Tintin learned the true story of the Unicorn ship. And according to Archie, Sakharine was a descendant of Red Rackham who intended to take revenge on him. Tintin then tells Archie that Sakharine doesn't just want revenge. Because if that's the case, Sakharine should have killed him long ago. The only reason why Sakharine let him live was that Sakharine needed directions to the sunken treasure. Then Tintin also said that the three notes on the Unicorn ship were the clues. They continued their journey to Bahar while Sakharine and his men were already docked at the pier. In Bahar, Tintin and Archie met the detective Thompson brothers. They handed over Tintin's wallet, which Silk had previously pickpocketed. Tintin, who got his wallet back, was very happy and lucky because the secret notes he kept were still in the wallet. Tintin then saw a large poster that read the Milanese Nightingale, a performance with the main star of a singer named Bianca. Finally, Tintin found out that Sakharine's secret weapon to get the Unicorn ship from the Sultanate of Bahar was Bianca. The scene then moves to Bahar's Sultan. Bianca is seen arriving there and is greeted by the Sultan. Bianca then introduces her bodyguard, who turns out to be Sakharine. He deliberately disguised himself as Bianca's bodyguard and took advantage of the situation to steal the third Unicorn ship replica. The show was about to begin. Tintin, worried he would be caught sneaking into the show, left his notes to Archie. They then watched a concert where Bianca was singing with high-pitched vocals. Bianca's loud voice hurts Archie's head, and Archie then leaves the performance room. While Archie was outside, Sakharine's men managed to snatch Tintin's notes that were in Archie's hand. Bianca's voice also shattered the protective glass of the Unicorn ship replica, and Sakharine's eagle took the notes inside the ship. Snowy tried to block the eagle but failed. Meanwhile, Tintin, who was with Archie, finally found out that Sakharine had taken his notes. Sakharine, who had managed to get three notes, immediately rushed to his ship. On the other hand, Tintin and Archie tried to chase him using a motorcycle. When they were chasing Sakharine, Archie, who saw it, took the initiative to shoot Sakharine's car using a bazooka, but it turned out that his weapon was upside down, and the shot hit the dam wall behind him. The dam then broke and caused a flood. Initially, Tintin managed to snatch the note from Sakharine's hand, but they were hit by the dam ruins, making Sakharine grab the note using his eagle. Tintin, who did not want to give up, continued to try to reclaim the note. And when he got it, Tintin accidentally saw a code created when the three notes were put together. Sakharine then took Archie and Snowy hostage and threatened to throw them both into the sea if Tintin would not release the note. But Tintin didn't care and tried to grab the note from Sakharine's eagle. Seeing this, Sakharine threw Archie and Snowy into the sea, and Tintin, who saw it, immediately released the notes to help them both. Sakharine managed to get the three notes and left from there. Meanwhile, Tintin, who managed to save Archie and Snowy, felt sad because he failed to get the note and finally chose to give up on pursuing Sakharine. But Archie was even angry with Tintin's attitude. Archie also said not to let him send the wrong message and make it difficult for people. He then said that if you fight for something, then you will hit the wall and push it down. Hearing Archie's sentence, Tintin realized he knew the radio signal on Sakharine's ship and would send a signal to Interpol towards the Karabujan ship, so the Interpol would know where the Sakharine ship was going. At the same time, the detective Thompson brothers arrived and saw an airplane in that place. Meanwhile, on the Caribou's ship, it turned out that the records Sakharine had obtained showed his place of origin. Nestor, who came to pick them up, was trapping Sakharine. Archie's heavy equipment lifted the car he was driving. Tintin and Detective Thompson also witnessed it there. The two detectives intend to arrest Sakharine because his arrest warrant from Interpol and the FBI has been issued. Sakharine, who is trapped in the car, has not given up. His men, who were still free, infiltrated the heavy equipment and helped him. Sakharine then jumped into another heavy equipment. Archie and Sakharine finally fight each other using heavy equipment. The battle between Sir Francis' descendants and Red finally began. At first, Archie almost lost, but he got up and threw several liquor bottles at Sakharine. Then Sakharine, who was cornered, threatened to burn the note. Fortunately, Tintin came to snatch the note by hanging on a rope like Tarzan. Archie then told Sakharine that by the storm no one would be able to take my ship. Then Archie threw Sakharine into the sea, and finally, Sakharine was caught. Tintin and Archie then examined the three notes showing a coordinate point. Then they rushed to the coordinates, which turned out to lead to Marline Spike Hall, where inside the house, Nestor was waiting for them. After traveling all the way here and there, it turns out that the treasure's location is very close to Tintin's house, which is also Archie's former home, which Sakharine once controlled. Archie also remembers that there is a secret underground warehouse in the house. Nestor then pointed out a small warehouse that was not the warehouse Archie was referring to. Then Snowy managed to find the hidden warehouse. Then Tintin remembers Archie, who said he hit the wall and knocked it down. Archie also knocked down the wall and stored treasure from the late Sir Francis in the warehouse. There they also found a globe, and according to Archie, there is an island on the globe that does not exist. Then Archie touches the island and then opens the globe. Archie finds Sir Francis' hat full of gold gems inside the globe, and Tintin also finds a treasure map there. The map shows where 400 kilograms of gold sunk. They both intend to continue their adventure, and the movie ends. The moral that can be learned from this movie is, everyone must be able to remember his true identity and also where he came from. In the story of Archie and Tintin who find out the secret of the unicorn ship after traveling to many places, they later find out that the real key is in Archie's memory. This is evident when Archie remembers who he is again and his family history. It turns out that the thing they have been looking for all this time until risking their lives is in Archie's house, which also happens to be very close to Tintin's house.